Amen. He didn't say multiply. He didn't say increase. He didn't say, just pray, sanctify, bless him. And I know that Peter right next to me, and John, and Andrew, hey Peter, give it to the disciples. Peter always has to be first. Yes, sir. Give it to the disciples. Give it to the disciples. And Peter looks at the basket, and it's only five fish, five bread, and it's only two fish. Hello? It's not even enough for me. Well, he had the other disciple take some, and when the other disciple was taking fish and bread, he keep multiplying. Then the other disciple to the other disciple until they got the 12 disciples with 12 baskets, and they got it, started passing to the people, and the bread was multiplied. See, brothers and sisters, the miracle did not take place when Jesus prayed. The miracle took place when the disciples believed. And when they moved in that faith, believing, that it was God. And many times in our lives, we pray for something and we just wait for that to happen, and it won't happen. The just shall live by faith. And faith is calling things that are not as though they were. So you have a need, you have a prayer request, you're asking for something, say, God Almighty, this is what I need, I pray to you, God, answer my prayer, I know you can do it. And then move. You gotta move. You're praying for a job, and you gotta go and knock doors. Turn in applications, make phone calls, get in the internet. Don't say, well, I pray for a job. If they need me, they call me. 1-800-GIMMY. And God doesn't work that way. I know God for some years now, and I know how God doesn't work that way. You want something, you pray, you believe, and then you gotta. When the priests were carrying the ark and they were gonna cross the Jordan River to the promised land, they came by the water's edge, and they stood there with the ark, and God told them, cross over. The water was there. The Bible says that it wasn't until they gave the first step and they got their sandals wet that the water stopped. The problem is that we don't want to get our sandals wet. You must trust in God. He gave it to the disciples to distribute. And when the disciples distributed, the miracle took place. Let me take it to another outstanding man, which is an inspiration to all of us. It's Moses. Moses. Moses was a man that had nothing. And the Lord had him in the school of training. And when the Lord has you in school, it's hard. But the Lord will train you. Okay. The Lord said to Moses, what is that in your hand? And he said, a rod. Said, a shepherd's rod. That's all I had. Now God called Moses and said, go and set my people free. Set my people free. Moses didn't want to go. He said, a shepherd brought him. He was taking care of a flock that was not his. But God was preparing him all these years because he was going to be the shepherd and he was going to take care of the flock of the children of Israel. That wasn't him either. It was the Lord's. So actually he was going to be working for someone else, which is God Almighty, which I don't think he minded, and I don't mind. But it was a process of training to prepare for the big job. Sharp Chinese proverb says that a long journey begins with the first step. And I'll say to you that your greatness, because God has called you for greatness, and you will accomplish greatness in your life. Before you go to Rose Hills, you're going to do great things. Hallelujah. Moses surrendered the rod that was in his hands.